The squirrel. Squirrel and a barber had a conversation. And then the barber flew away and the squirrel went his own way. Okay, squirrel's gone, barber's still there. Barber's gone following the squirrel. Who knows what a squirrel and a crested barber have to talk about on a hot afternoon. Use your imagination. With Alice and the Mad Hatter. Indeed. You're late for a very important date. Okay, so I'm way behind on questions and things because I got a little bit carried away. The next question was, I even said it, Chris. Get back to it. This is the King Alan Hewitt. There's giraffe tracks. Maybe there's. Oh, and there's giraffe over there. Thank you, King Alan Hewitt. Okay, well, let's get a good view of these twiggers because we haven't seen giraffe for a while. Let's spend some time with some of Africa's tallest animals. Right here around the bend. Just like me, round the bend. Two there. Maybe this is the family that's come back. We haven't seen them, but there's a big bull. There's a big cow right up ahead of us. What we want to do is we want to get a little bit further west of them. Oh, and elephant have closed the road. Decided that. And there's another female. Look how pretty she is. Let's just stop here for now. Oh. Beautiful light on them. King Alan Hewitt. Yes, Mr. Alan Hewitt. The most unusual mating rituals of animals. I suppose giraffe. Probably one of them because of the way they wrap their necks around each other. Animals don't have that much of a mating thing. As much as maybe birds and lizards and snakes and insects, where display is all of what it's all about. Animals have a gift that foregoes all of that to some extent, in that there are pheromones. I suppose all the other insects have pheromones. I mean, think of a moth that can pick up the female pheromones. Or the pheromones of a female moth, one in a billion. I mean, it's unbelievable how a male moth can sense a female moth. But strangely enough, animals don't really have that fantastic or intricate or they just don't have. Male picks up the pheromones and goes and sniffs the female and they get to go. This is what's happening here. That big boy over there. I'm not going to go closer right now. I'll just stop and get a look at their heads over the trees for the time being because there does seem to be something going on there. He's a very big boy. He's a very dark chocolate giraffe. She's a bit skinny in the neck. I don't know if that's a compliment to a giraffe or not. But he's standing very proud. And he's also displaying to any other giraffe, any other bull giraffe in the area, that he has got total ownership here. It's almost like a proud stance that challenge me at your peril. Crack your cervical vertebra with a single punch of my ossicones. The horns on a giraffe are known as ossicones, and their manner of settling disputes is to swing those little stubby ossicones at each other with the fulcrum of the neck and the weight of the head, punch each other in the shoulder and the neck, and inflict enough that your opponent gives up and moves away. I think he fell asleep and he forgot that she's moved off. Mr. G, the lady's gone. Or maybe you've got to throw a coin in the cup for him to move. He's displaying to somebody, his ears are back, he's holding a posture that is I'm just guessing. Explaining what I'm seeing, what I'm interpreting. You are quite the man. Interesting. Ah, he's holding that pose. Let's see if we can find another member of this group. I think it was us who was playing it with us, because now that we've moved, he's moved.